question is, since the power is now in Baghdad, now the president is having 10 years after 2010. Are you guys in your party going to live in another 5 years so that we're good for 15 years? My second question is that you guys are being particular about land being grabbed by the nomads. Why in the Southern Sudan, for example, I'm sure some of my land are being grabbed. We are told that you are the person in charge of the land commission and you don't want to make a reconciliation on the land commission because we heard you want to stand for the 2015 and you are a friend of Andrew Well. The thing is that you guys are led to lava code. And you talk of a democratic system. We heard that you have threatened Namakon not to be in the Southern Sudan, and you know what, you just have to stop. Is it true or not?
Peter Carlos says power was in Bahrain, it should go back to Upper Nile. This should not be the basis. Each party will choose their person whom they want to be their presidential candidate. It could come from anywhere, they're choosing, and if they feel that with that person they will win the presidency, then that is the decision of the party. And finally, the decision is left to the population. I always don't accept the idea that we divide ourselves into Greater Baragazar, Greater Upper Nile, Greater Equatorial. Doesn't serve much. Look at yourselves as South Sudanese. Now, if there is going to be division, let it be in the parties. That party X has a candidate. Party X has a candidate. By that, we will create a viable state. But if we go regional, we will not go forward. So, and that is why I spoke much about the SPLM, the need of the SPLM. Those who have other parties can create their parties. That Namakon is being threatened. Namakon is not being threatened. The SPLM-DC has members in parliament. It also has members in the State Assembly of Upper Nile. This is the two areas where the SPLM, the National Parliament, it has members, and it has members in Upper Nile State. Nobody is threatening Lam, but Lam is being accused that he is supporting the armed rebellion. And by law, if you raise arms against the state, you're committing treason. Party politics is open. Anybody can create a party as they wish. I had a discussion with the SPLM-DC. I told them, by the way, you correct the situation of Lam. If he is still the leader of the SPLM-DC, these things we hear that he is supporting armed rebellion is not going to make you register, because the law says no party will have an army. See, no party will have an army. We must conform to that law. And you cannot fight a war and you're also
a registered political party. You choose one. If you think that your issues cannot be handled by talking in political party forum, and you think you will fight, and you will get support, this is different. See? So, for those who are in contact with Islam, it's important that he clears himself on the question of supporting armed rebellion. The party SPLM-DC is still in parliament. It works. But when the registration comes, every party will be asked, who is your leader? We know he's the leader of SPLM-DC. And if he's being accused and with evidence that he's supporting armed rebellion, then the SPLM-DC would fail to qualify as a political party, you know?